It's dangerous stuff. What's the impact that you see with lead?
I think every mom appreciates the danger of lead. When you peel the lead paint, it would destroy the ability of kids to learn, drops IQ dramatically. But I'll tell you, in adults, infertility can be caused by lead issues. A lot of belly pain, continuous nausea, all these things that you might attribute to the world around you, some crazy allergy that you don't really have, it could be because of lead, but you're paying money to put in your body because you don't know what's there because people aren't gonna bother checking. And in terms of the mind, Phil.
Yeah, cognitively, this is a real toxic substance because it can create irritability. It creates a fuzziness of mind and inability to concentrate. And with children, it really can create developmental problems with them. And for women, it can accumulate in the bone, and postmenopausal, it releases this lead. So years later, it can release and create problems in your organs. So this is just bad stuff. And the fact that they're putting our names on it to validate it just really burns me up. They're cheating people and putting their health at risk and using our names to sell it.
If you think about how reprehensible these people are, if they're stealing your money, that's bad, but then they're stealing your health on top of it, right? You're paying money to hurt yourself. Maybe if you'd actually bought a good product, it could have helped you with that terrible pain you're having, that insomnia you suffer with. Now you just don't know.
Yeah, and Doc, you make such a good point that this isn't a one-shot deal. People are applying this day after day, week after week.
With ramifications years and decades down the line.
I think the reason, Phil, this isn't illegal, because you'd think if you're watching the show right now, you'd be jumping up and down saying there should be a law. Well, this is one of those rare times when I would say, well, yeah, I think we ought to be able to make this illegal so you can't do this and get away with it, which is what happens. We ought to have a more specific list of things that you have to prove is true for your product before you can verify that it's safe.
Yeah, it should be criminalized. If it's not, it should be.
CBD by itself has some positive utility. There's probably good stuff that can come from CBD, but we do that sort of thing through the FDA. We need the FDA to make this a nutritional supplement, at least, so that there are regulations around it.
In the meantime, I don't sell it, Dr. Oz doesn't sell it, nope. And if you see our names on an ad, you know you're being scammed.
Dr. Phil and Dr. Oz expose fake ads.
This is highly toxic.
It is not safe for human consumption under any circumstance.
They're cheating people and putting their health at risk and using our names to sell it.
New Dr. Phil. Check your local listings.
Hey, did you like that video? Well, click subscribe and ring the bell to get notifications. You won't want to miss what I have coming up.